started. Relatively easy agenda today. Looking at the viewer pipeline, we just promoted the latest mate viewer, which had, God, I don't know what it was, dozens of assorted fixes in it. And so that's out, and its crash rate is really good, which is nice. We are going to be getting an update on another update on the Bento viewer. We have a fix pending. Veer, do you want to characterize that?
Yeah, I think this is probably everybody's favorite bug, which is the ever-growing groin bug. It wasn't an Easter egg, but it was definitely not supposed to be there. The next Bento RC will have a fix for that, and I'm really hoping it will be the last Bento RC, but we will see.
Firestorm, no fair putting in a switch that leaves that bug in there. I know that might be a popular option, but there you go. So not sure exactly when that fix is going to QA now, and I'm not sure whether we'll do an update next week or not. It's holiday week. We're constrained about what we can update during holiday weeks. So that may or may not go out next week, but it's in the queue and will be coming out quickly thereafter. Let's see, other viewers that are out there. The 64-bit project continues. We're getting close to actually building 64-bit viewers, so that's pretty exciting. Thank you to Nikki for lots and lots of patches. The 360 snapshot project viewer is also getting a steady stream of updates. We still have some issues to address with that, and just how far we'll be able to get it to work with the interest list problems remains to be seen. So, it seems to work better if you look around real slowly before you take a picture, but there do seem to be cases where things don't show up. So we're going to have to spend some time on that. But that's out there and is doing pretty well. Let's see, there'll be a bunch of changes that will come out in some version of the 64-bit viewer for how we do checking for updates and how we manage the viewer process. We'll probably talk about those sometime in December in detail. So we'll have some discussions about that to try and make some of the process handling more robust and separate the update checks from the rest of the code. I don't think it's anything you'll have any trouble adapting to your own purposes. Since we're not changing our server side, if you're compatible with our server side now, you'll be compatible with it in the future. So let's see. And there's a new maintenance viewer that will be appearing shortly that's got yet another big collection of random fixes, some of which are, still in QA. Let's see. And then we also have Steven here today. He wants to talk about changes to how we're doing status plugging. Is he actually here somewhere?
Steven, I'm here. Right here.
There he is.
Yep.
Yeah. Take it away.
Sure. This status blog seems to be the only reason I come to these meetings. Because last time I was here, I was talking about moving it to moving it away from our original platform onto the one we're on now. And now I'm here to talk about moving it to a different provider for a variety of reasons. The new status page is going to be done by statuspage.io. We're doing all of our development at that URL for right now. the RSS feed may change. So those of you that have viewers that hit the RSS feed directly may need to update it to one of these URLs. That's pretty much it.
The new one, as you can, as you'll see, if you look at it, looks cooler and has much more detailed information about what's working and what isn't.
We're actually playing with it right now, internally. April and I are playing with this to show exactly what we can and what we can't do. We actually have this set up in our internal chat system, so we can actually set these statuses from our internal chat. So we don't actually have to go to the website to do it. And also, I can demo that to you as well whenever you, want to.
That's great. Right now, we have kind of this more elaborate than it needs to be multi-person process that we have to go through. So it'll be great to be able to do those quickly.
Yeah, we can do all of this quickly and just by chatting to a bot, it'll do it for us.
Very cool.
We're looking to launch this on the 28th of November, which is the Monday after Thanksgiving.
Right. And if anybody has any redirect at the existing status page.
But yes.
They may need to redirecting... do something different for the RSS feed.
Yes.
Okay.
We're going to redirect the status.secondlifegrid.net, and we might also be redirecting status.secondlife.com as well. That was another thing that was raised to me, so we'll be pointing those two as well.
Great.
Any questions? You know, hit me up. Otherwise, thanks.
Those are up now. Can they be experimenting with those at this point?
They can experiment.
They don't accurately reflect the grid status right now.
No. No. They don't accurately. No, they don't. We're actually just, as I said, I was giving a demo earlier. We were just playing around with it, and April actually was just now poking at this. She was actually testing the SMS notification, because you can actually subscribe your phone to it, and it will send you a text message whenever anything on the grid changes. So that's what we were playing with.
Cool. So for the time being, you can test against those for the purposes of seeing whether or not your software reads them correctly and that sort of thing. But until we say so, they don't accurately reflect what's going on in the grid.
Correct.
And that is intended to be the 28th?
That's intended to be the 28th, yes.
Cool. All right. Great. Fun with new tech.
Yep, absolutely.
And I think that's the end of my agenda. So the floor is open. Oh, Izzy asked me to mention that he's got a conflicting meeting now and may not be able to be here on a regular basis for at least for a while. So, but of course, I'll be able to carry feedback back to them as needed. No topics? Gonna let me off really early today?
Yeah, Worley, on that one, and that's why I'm here, actually. I keep hearing internally and in the Jira's and all that, I see references to fixing it on the server. If someone could possibly add a comment or send me a line someplace explains what that actually would be, I'd love to learn that. It sounds like we've bounced back and forth with different changes on the viewer that affect the change, and essentially, and a bunch of that is, I think very viewer. That's where that functionality is actually implemented. It does sound like we're kind of stuck with, one way breaks some people's content, and the other way breaks other people's content. It's a knotty problem. Okay, I'll check with Andre and see what he thinks could be done on the server. As far as I know, like the right click, that's all happening viewer side, and the server doesn't know you right clicked until you actually do something. Yeah, right. Well, and that's a tough one. From what I understand, we fixed it and we made it work the way it is supposed to work based on sort of intuition and documents. And, other people have already built stuff compensating for the bug, and that breaks their stuff. And so, who's right? Short answer is I don't know, but it's a nasty problem.
When we get a combination of changes, either viewer side or server side or both, that we think addresses the problem, I think this is one of those cases where we're going to want to put that combination out in a project viewer and in a simulator on a DD, and then invite everybody that's got a weapon or a device that is affected by these problems to go and test with that combination.
I made it. Better late than ever.
So we were just speculating about whether or not there is enough information to know about whether or not there's a combination of fixes that will fix the gun problems. But the current situation is that we don't really know.
Do you guys like drastically, terribly hate Firestorm for breaking Horizons?
It's okay. We'll blame you.
I figured you would. Although, I actually think that we made the right choice there, because the alternative is worse. Seems to be.
I don't think there isn't a perfect solution, because if we we fix like SVC 75 or 32, that breaks, and that's what the one you didn't pick up. I actually think Drake's suggestion right there might be it's ugly as heck, but you know, some obscure toggle in the advanced or develop menu that turns that behavior one way or the other may be the shortest path to have viewers that can, you know, run and work in different places.
So it's a problem with Alchemy as well, then. I'm so glad we're not alone. Of course, we couldn't have known that we were going to break Horizons because we didn't know about Horizons. Well, it works with London Viewer, so it's not a problem for everybody. I don't think too many combat people use the Linden Viewer, though.
Well, but we don't want to leave it in that state. So we'll have to keep. I find myself kind of confused by the whole situation, but that's okay.
Well, as long as you don't hate us too much for breaking Horizons.
We're all family, and we have to live together and survive. So
yes, exactly.
My question is that SVC 7532, is that essentially the problem? You know, there's no other, or are there other LLT controls behaviors that, you know, are causing problems and so on? I unless it's like a nasty bug, I don't like changing existing behavior because
that there is analytic controls with experience key. I don't know, is it related really? We've discovered it on the gateway with the Mad Pig game that the HUD doesn't always detach even after they've left the region. I don't think it's related to this, but it is another LLT controls issue.
Okay.
And also if you're driving a particular vehicle when you are attached to the HUD, it kills your controls for the vehicle and you end up stuck. You have to unset off the vehicle and then reset. Yeah, well, at least there's a Jira for that.
Yeah, okay. And those sounds like straightforward, you know, bugs that just, yeah, it's bad behavior.
Well, that's a fairly new one. And I don't know if it might be just coincidence, but it seemed to come around the time you guys added the experience sit function. I don't know if it's related, though.
Yeah, it's very possible. That's the only experience-related stuff I think we've done in a while, server-side.
Yeah.
It's very possible that since code got changed in that area, something snuck in.
We at least got a Jira there. Okay, 3. Such an overachiever.
Okay, and they got to take place in the event. Yeah, that totally. You're setting off. Do experiences grant you permission or control permissions?
Yes. I can't remember now.
Yeah, I'd have to look, but that, I mean,
I'm gonna go look.
In either case, we're talking about messing with permissions while you're in the middle of permissions callback, you know, so yes, the fact that.
But it didn't happen before. It used to be that residents could, because we got these little bubbles, and they could drive the bubbles into the MADP area, and the MADP HUD would automatically, unfortunately, be attached, and you would still have your vehicle. So some behavior has changed at some time.
Yep. Okay, so yeah, those bugs, that looks like a straightforward problem, and yeah, it got introduced, or you know, it's been sitting around for a bit. And that, yeah, that's something we should look at. I think that obviously is not, or, you know, it's a bug, but it's not causing the degree of trouble that the
no, the gun thing is definitely a priority. And, yeah.
Yeah, the other one. So, yeah, I wish there was an obvious solution. I guess I will try and check with Andre, who apparently said there was some server-side possible fix, but I'd love to hear what why he thinks that.
Well, it puts us in a bit of a spot too, because on account we have, since you guys are gearing up to get Bento out, we're gearing up to get Bento out, and if there is a viewer-side code, you guys are too. So if there is viewer side code in order to fix this bug, then I have to ask myself, do I want to wait for that and hold Bento, or get Bento
wait.
Out?
Don't
okay.
Wait.
So we'll keep it. So we're just going to keep Horizons broken then. Unfortunately, unless Drake's suggestion, perhaps.
Yeah, I don't know how much code is involved with this.
How much? Drake, do you have a pointer to what you did there? Ew. And Sarah's not going to like that.
Okay, for anyone who wants to get geeky, that is the code change that's linked to SVC 7532. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's not pretty, obviously, to have a switch somewhere that says work around this bug or not. I have no idea what command in the UI would look like, but there are a lot of debug settings and there are a lot of menu items and varied options here and there. So it wouldn't be the first thing we've added that's a little bit hacky. It would be the fastest way to get things to work. But yeah, I don't know this viewer code particularly well. Looks like they're basically using different flag for the what's going on.
Jake, are you doing the if else based on the experience that's being initiated, or by region? Where are you doing that? Oh, I see. Ew. That's horrible.
This is one of those cases where I wish I had a time machine.
Yeah.
Yep. Those could fix a lot. Yeah, that's...
Go back and tell people, no, don't use the same control for two different things in two different modes. Don't give the users control and use it for viewer control. Too late.
That's before Viewer 2.0, isn't it?
Way before, yeah.
Like way before.
Viewer
2. You guys didn't recycle Viewer.
2010, right?
Yeah, you guys didn't recycle Viewer 1 code to Viewer 2.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, yes.
Yeah, there's a lot of code that's in common. Ah. It's a normal descendant. It's just
a Heinz 57.
Buff touched.
Yeah, I mean, that's obviously there's a huge amount of UI, but the underlying stuff, or the rendering pipeline and all that stuff didn't.
Oh, a render pipeline, yeah. Because there is nobody who can fix that stuff.
I don't think we're in a position to make any announcement about anything because we haven't figured out what we're going to do about it. So, if it looks as though...
Oh, you can't make people re-script stuff, because that's just not going to happen.
Right, but that doesn't mean we can't update the advice on how to avoid pitfalls. And then, of course, anybody who is still actively maintaining something will be free to re-script it to make it match the new advice. But I don't think we know what the new advice is going to be yet. So that's kind of a moot point.
This is an extremely long shot, but I could be hopeful. Does anyone know, or is there a way to figure out, you know, at this point, what does the user really want? I guess we know they're in mouse look. It's really just a crapshoot of whether we want them to be panning or passing that along and shooting, right? Yeah, I didn't think so.
Well, you want the behavior to match what the expectations are with, you know, most games that involve shooting. Yeah, but there's sort of an unspoken general commonality between most games with mouse look and shooting. There are some games that drift away from, you know, the typical, but... You know what would be cool? Some games take advantage of mice that have extra buttons. That would be cool, but now we're talking about adding stuff.
No!
Would it be incredibly ugly, hacky, hard to figure out if,
would it?
You know, the shift key changed the behavior or something?
Yeah.
No. That would not be
maybe not, no, yeah, or you could just have additional assignments. So, for example, a lot of mice have a scroll wheel, and that is accounted for. That there's a function for that, but some have a scroll wheel that you can also click, and that click could be used and assigned to something.
Yeah.
All mice have a scroll wheel that can click. It's like a standard button.
Do they all click?
Yes, all of them click.
Ah. It's called progress.
That's not progress, that's from the 70s.
No, they didn't have clicks back then. They had ball mice.
They had weird clicky mice, too, in one of the Xerox labs.
But I do think, though, that you shouldn't, that you should, you know, if at all possible, not leave existing weapons broken. There's a lot of weapons still being used in SL, content creators who have since left.
Yeah, and the problem of keeping legacy content alive is huge, and, you know,
yeah.
Keeping SL content alive is something obviously we want to do. We really truly don't like breaking stuff. Makes everybody unhappy. So yeah, that's why we're here. I can't think of a solution off the top, you know, right now looking at this problem that, you know, if we make it work one way, these people are unhappy and this is broken, and if we can make it work another way, those people are unhappy and that is broken. And you know, so neither of those solutions are particularly
good. Can't you make everybody happy? Come on.
Yeah.
So it's SL, there's always a way to make everybody happy.
Right. Well, that's, you know, the only thing I can think of is like, you know, here's the switch. Throw it, yeah, you know, up if you want to be happy this way, or down if you want to be happy that way, and you know, use that toggle. And then everyone's happy, or it's a, and
well, see, now you're talking about in line with sort of the Firestorm mentality, is just make it an option, make everything optional.
Well, I am a coder, you know, I like these things, and I like to watch the expression on UI designers' faces when you bring them up, and, you know, and I also, you know, it's esoteric and it's ugly, and I fully acknowledge all that, but. You know, and so,
well, and the other thing is trying to explain it to residents, because they'll be like, well, yeah, what does this option do? Nobody will understand it anyway.
Yeah, why? Yeah, I went into Horizons and why is this broken? You know,
yeah.
Or I went into, you know, started shooting my gun and it's broken. And yeah, so that's the only thing that I've got or in that I can envision right now that actually makes a version of the viewer work with these two different things. I don't know. So yeah, you know, if anyone's got any other ideas, certainly speak up. So I mean, no Carter or Roz or anybody else. But that's kind of where it looks at this point. Looks like at this point, just from, you know, I'm somewhat new to the problem, but unless Andre.
Well, if I had to weigh Horizons in one hand and all the rest of the weapons in Second Life in the other hand, I know which arm is going to get tired quicker.
I'm not in the position to make those decisions.
No, I realize that. I'm just.
I will note that the weather's really nice today and things like that.
Yeah, and I got an arm that's getting really tired.
You know, and we're kind of, with the Horizon stuff, we're in a horrible position because, you know, we basically
That's a big promo thing.
It's a promo thing. We don't want to break it, and we obviously don't want to break it with our viewer.
Well, what about re-scripting the gun, though? As Rurley suggests. I mean, that seems to be the almost a similar...
Library pop gun?
Yeah, or, well, whatever gun that they're using. I haven't actually tried Ryzen's.
Yeah, okay. I don't know. Is there a... So, basically...
Because it really, apparently, is just Horizons affected by this because of the way that the gun was scripted.
Well, I don't know what re-scripting that would entail or what actually the fix is or so on and so forth. I mean, I guess, like Rurley says, the Forest Quest one. Yep. I think we've gone full circle a couple times here.
In other words, subject change. Okay, who's Stephen Linden? I haven't met Stephen Linden before. Hello, Stephen Linden.
Hello.
You're not new. You're 5 years old, but you're new to me.
Stephen came to warn us about upcoming changes to the status blog here.
Oh.
The people who were here on time got the details.
Sorry about that. I was stuck in traffic. I was really trying to get home in time. I was stuck in traffic. It's the truth. Oh, did you? I haven't even... Quite literally, I ran upstairs. I jumped on the computer. I clicked sign in. I saw Worley's message, said just 10 minutes to third part of your meeting. I said, fuck, and then I logged in.
I got woken up by the mail truck.
The mail truck?
Yes, I heard the mail truck, and it woke me up. And then it was like, oh, it's time for the meeting. Wow, I'm actually awake for the meeting today.
Wait, you were sleeping in the middle of the day?
I work nights.
Oh, that sucks.
So typically my sleeping time is right in the middle of when this meeting is.
Sleep is overrated.
Sleep is good for me. I have a dog bite injury on my foot.
A what?
A dog bit my foot a few days, like last week, and it's been awful.
Did you give the dog rabies?
That's rude!
That dog should get shots.
Okay, any other actual Second Life-related topics?
Yeah, sorry about that.
No, it's all right.
It's nice to meet you, Stephen. Something. I'm sorry.
I'll contribute more things next week while you're on vacation.
Who's on vacation?
I'll be around.
Who's going on
I'll
vacation?
I'll be around Monday through Wednesday.
The Lindens. Yeah, it's Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's Thanksgiving.
Oh, right.
So
of course.
Lots of people are going to be out next week. And so we won't be doing any major roles or anything like that next week. And, right, Thursday and Friday are our company holidays.
What chance have you had?
A particle issue from 2003.
Particle issues. Oh, boy.
It's the selection beam particle. It's a funny little bug. It's great.
Okay.
It doesn't break anything. That's the great part. It just makes selection beams look nicer.
So Bento is definitely not coming out until after Thanksgiving.
It looks like we'll do another update between now and Thanksgiving, assuming that it gets through QA over the weekend.
Ah, so another release candidate.
A new
or project viewer.
An RC update. Yes.
Okay. And then. Well, then everyone's on holidays, and then...
And then if everything is going well, the following week we'll look at whether or not it's good to promote Bento.
So
you guys
will
stop finding bugs.
Hey, you encouraged it.
Yeah. No, it's all good.
Our preview group... I'm just going to go look really quick here. Preview group.
Well, and of course, your implementation is still a couple of updates behind.
Well, that's, yeah. Well, it isn't exactly. We're going to be issuing a new one. The minute I get done here, I'm going to upload it to the server. Assuming it built properly, we're going to upload it to the server, and it will be going out to the preview group.
Yeah, find out if that Mac bug is really, really, really fixed. I would really, really like to know.
Well, keep an eye in the preview group, because, in fact, Bento is responsible for super-duper popular 4,800 people in that preview group now. And probably two-thirds of that came from Bento.
Because I totally have more gentle hack glue I can apply to that.
Well, the nice thing about the preview group is they're not skilled. They're not like beta testers. They don't necessarily know technical stuff. But when they notice something broken, they come in and they scream and they whine. You know, what? Why is this doing that? So as long as we're keeping an eye on it, we'll tend to find or discover little issues. It's a good little test bed. Well, some do, yeah. Yeah, well, Catwa initially leaked the link, so Catwa should be... Well, she was punished, kind of. Because we blocked that version and then waited for 2 days. we will be blocking the author that's in there now, by the way.
I've just been releasing builds of Alchemy with Bento in them to the secret little tiny QA team that doesn't exist. Because they're secret.
Okay.
Willie, can you shift? Actually, I can check. Sorry, go ahead.
No, it's okay.
Are you trying to quit early? But I'm here.
Allowing for the possibility.
Pause. I have a question.
Okay.
Voice updates coming. I would really love voice updates because whenever I plug in a USB device, voice crashes and it's driving me crazy. It's fixed in newer VBox.
That was fixed in a couple of voice updates ago.
But it crashes again when I plug in a really specific headset that shows up as a keyboard.
Oh. Is that by what was it that they told us they had a fix for? It was a PlayStation device, a camera or something?
That thing too. That thing shows up a mouse, a keyboard, a camera, and a microphone.
Yeah, and it actually has four microphones.
Yeah, I remember that because I actually fixed the Linux the issue with that in the Linux kernel.
Right. Yeah, Vivox told us their next update will have a fix for that. I forget what the symptom it had was, but there's a fix for it coming. Currently the voice update is held up by the fact that we found a bunch of problems with Max in terms of the voice attenuation with distance and direction. It turns out that if somebody's standing to your right, then all the distance attenuation works. But if they're standing a little to your left, they attenuate really, really fast. They get 7 or 8 meters away and you can't hear them anymore. So we're waiting for fixes for that. And then we'll push the next voice update.
Yay.
So the good news is they've reproduced the problem on their test rig. So that's usually what it takes for them to figure out these things. So that they don't have to run all of Second Life to debug it.
Imagine that's a pain for them.
Well, you know, it's the business they're in. So, I'm hoping that we'll get a fix for that pretty soon, and then we'll have other update to voice, and we'll push that. I think that's that should be a public repository, the Viewer Vivox repository, Linden Lab Viewer Vivox. I think it's Linden Lab Viewer Vivox. Yes, Linden Lab Viewer Vivox is where I do the testing of builds from there. The server-side voice updates are kind of on hold because there were other projects on the server side that are higher priority. So we're not working on that. Hopefully someday we'll get back to it.
There are voice quality improvements coming.
Yeah, some new.
How about new I got a suggestion. How about I would not have been late for this meeting if there was a phone app that could use voice. So there you go.
That is not actually that hard to do.
Would be nice though. Look how popular SLGO was until they sold out.
Yeah, but actually, their major users were not mobile users.
No, that's a point. Okay, fair enough.
Major users were people on old machines with graphics who wanted to see what the people with good graphics were getting.
But it was very popular.
Oops.
Oh, I see you're trying to escape.
No,
I'm just trying to sneak off.
Accidentally clipped on my...
Yeah, now we know what you're really doing.
It's a totally non-viewer-related question, Oz.
What's that?
Why is this theater thing Fulbright?
I like Fulbright, for the record.
Because that's the way the person who built it.
It makes me sad because it lights weirdly. Because it ignores lighting.
I made the mistake of speaking in the preview group, and I'm regretting it now.
I just like making weird and vague hints in the Alchemy support group and seeing what people say. It's really great, and they all hate me.
Oh, we were the only ones that messed with the residents.
I should just gently untick the Fulbright box on this thing, and it would look so much better.
Clickbait, Faz.
I'm trying to decide whether to put the screens back.
I
de-rendered them a long time ago. Have you actually got rid of them?
I actually removed them. Recently.
Because the problem with MediaPrim is that bloody URL thing that hovers over top of everything, and it doesn't scale if you zoom in and out. It's horrible.
Right. But I'm kind of... Oh, that's interesting. The table went away, too.
Yeah, because the table was linked to the signs, believe it or not.
Hmm.
Good builder.
I don't know why that was.
Good builder. That's quality stuff.
Well, anyway... I haven't decided whether to bring those back or not.
Yeah, the table was linked to them. Because when I derendered the signs, I lost the table.
I could put a table there without any problem.
It's put the table back. Because, having a bunch of tape recorders floating in the air is kind of strange considering there's all these chairs floating in the air.
Right.
Perfectly natural.
Yeah, you should kill the Fulbright, though. It would look so much better.
Oh, by the way, since I'm telling a person, so there's a person giving me kudos on the alpha build being a smoother performance, and I'm pointing out that actually that's the lab magic. What did you guys do to make it faster?
They optimized the joints.
Is that what it is? Is that really what it was? General consensus has been that the bento has a much higher frame rate.
Okay, so for the longest time, because I did some performance profiling that I gave to Veer, for the longest time, though, the largest bottleneck in avatar rendering has been just iterating over all the joints. And it just got exponentially worse when people started wearing more and more rigged mesh, because it just added more things that need to be iterated over per frame, because it also it has to do a search in a map using string comparisons, which are slow.
But we don't have the joint fixes. Actually, we would now, Giddy, because we're about to send out, unless it's not in...
If you've got reasonably current bento code, then you would have the joint fixes. Those have been in there for, I don't know, a month or something?
Yeah.
Oh, then we probably have that. That's probably in our current preview, then.
And there was a matrix multiply that was also done, like, I think it was, I was standing in a furry club, and it was done 29,000 times per frame.
Oh, yeah, we switched one of those to SSE, which may also be helping some.
Yeah, doing that in SSE greatly helps it. The thing last week was fixing the fact of it was overflowing the hardware vertex uniform limit on certain GPUs. Which will still happen on really old GPUs. Really, really old.
Yeah, I don't think we've really gotten any feedback on that bug since the fix went out, so hopefully that means everybody's happy now.
It would only be a problem on some really, really old Intel integrated chips and some really, really, really old ATI stuff. Because NVIDIA supported, like, a giant just pile of Vertex uniforms since the GeForce 8000 series way back in 2007 or 8.
Most of the bug reports we got were actually people on NVIDIA not disputing that there could be even older ones that are...
That specific part of it was only... It's due to Apple being a super special snowflake about how they implement their driver for NVIDIA.
Snowflake. That's not what I would call them.
Right there. That exact same hardware on any other platform that NVIDIA directly supports themselves supports 4,096 Vertex uniforms per Balun program, if I remember right. And what was causing it to overflow was everything on a GPU is allocated as a VEC4, regardless of if you're just using a single float. Or a VEC3. Or a 3x3 matrix. A 3x3 matrix is actually 4 columns of 3. So when you're just like using a float or something, or a large array of something, it's less than a nice, happy multiple of 4. You're actually wasting uniform slots. but really overrunning that limit is. I've never actually seen anyone manage to do that in production beyond Second Life, which was amazing. Should I contribute the fix for the Pac-Man stars yet?
Wait, Pac-Man stars?
I don't recall. Oh, the fact that stars render as little squares?
If you actually manage to zoom in really close on a star, it actually looks like a Pac-Man up close. Because the vertex
line is... I always wondered why people zoom in on things that much, but...
Well, it's an actual bug. The vertex winding is backwards.
I'm happy to have a look at it.
Somebody wrote it in clockwise winding, and it needs to be in counterclockwise because OpenGL is counterclockwise.
Okay. And you can only see it if you zoom in on the stars all the way.
But you can see it normally if you just look up and look really close, and they look kind of clear.
See, that's the thing. I just don't have the eye for detail that... Lots of you seem to have. That's.
I get irritated.
I think
when
that's
wind light
a good thing for me.
Like wind light being broken, it ruins my.
If Linden Lab had the eye for detail that the users have, we would have no bugs in Second Life.
Either that, or you'd have more because you were constantly trying to fix things.
Because every time you fix something, you break something.
Yeah.
'Tis the way it goes. Yeah, that's true. It never release. Every time we get close to release, Whirly goes into like overdrive to find blockers.
That's what I've been doing. I've been trying to find blockers beyond the fact that Windows 32 bit doesn't work, but that's not critical.
Wait, what? Windows 32 bit?
On Alchemy, Windows 32 bit does not build at the current time.
It's not compiling.
Oh, I haven't fixed it in months. I don't care about it. I fix it right before release usually and just pray to God there's nothing wrong with it.
Oh, that's terrible.
Well, as much as we might like to, we certainly don't plan to drop
something. Well, for my users, because since I can see my own download stats, most of them are actually on all the 64-bit builds.
Incidentally, I don't know if I mentioned this here before, the strategy we're going to try to deal with the HD 2000, 4000 problem on Windows 10 is that our 32-bit build will not have the manifest in it, and therefore will, we hope, remain compatible with those otherwise unsupported chipsets. And the 64-bit build will have the manifest in it so that it'll detect versions correctly and so forth and so on.
And that was a good thing.
We're going to try to make sure that we automatically update people into the right channels. Which will be a little tricky, but hopefully our new updating code will make it possible for us to do that.
Yeah, there is a fix for that Shiro and me kind of hammered together. That's an alpha. That's a weird alpha bug. That's sort of an issue.
Kitty, you may be able to piggyback on our fix if you change your builds to match. But that I don't expect those fixes, that new updater code, to appear even in the 64-bit branch until sometime in December at the earliest.
Oz, I have a weird question. Are you guys planning on adding HTTP2 support to the CDN anytime soon?
Sorry?
Are you guys planning on supporting HTTP2 on the CDN fetching?
It's not in the short-term plan, no.
Because that would have basically none of the issues that pipelining has had at all.
I am aware that in theory that would be an improvement. And I hope that at some point we'll get to actually experiment with that. But it's not in the short-term plan. Well, yeah, the antivirus software is not something we can do much about.
Yeah, antivirus software is such a pain. I had some person whining that Alchemy contained a virus because false positives on SL plugin.
So we had a recurring problem every time we did a release with Norton, kept flagging us, and we contacted Norton.
They created
a Second Life account, and they logged in, and they found our region. This was when we had just the one place, and they figured out how to use Second Life, figured out how to find us, and they were asking people, you know, do you know Jessica Lyon, trying to figure out how to reach us in world. Ed was there. He called me. I logged in and found them. They actually created an account, and they fixed it on the spot. We've never had a problem since with Norton.
I would imagine if you actually had some SL user that works for some NTEC, there's probably a furry, because I know a few furries there.
Well, he was just the default avatar, one of the library avatars, and he really was from Norton, because we had correspondence through email after that. Fantastic guy. I was just so impressed, very impressed, really good. Oh, look at that! It's almost 10 minutes after. I'm sure it's not related to me being here though.
And we still have Oz here, and it's amazing, and Oz is wonderful.
But the other Lindens are slowly dropping off. It is Friday, after all. Thanks, Vera. <yeah. laughs>
It is Friday, and...
Actually, I have some fixes for SL plugin, Jess, if people want them. It makes antiviruses less angry because you're not doing a direct mem copy over a system function pointer.
Oh. Okay. Just point Whirly at those, because you point her at those things anyways. And then she'll point those to Ansarial, or if you talk to Ansarial directly.
It's something really specific about how you're supposed to deal with system function pointers in kernel 32.dll, and that's actually a protected memory space, and when you're mem copying over it, it gets really, really unhappy and sets off all of these antivirus heuristics.
Oh, that's interesting.
I've had a long and difficult week dealing with many bugs and bugs.
I just don't want to be, you know, put in the same sort of areas, Apple.
You mean Apple and their super duper special MacBook with a weird touch bar instead of function keys?
Yeah, isn't that great?
I don't even know how to use that computer.
One USB port. Like, they took the phone jack out of their iPhone, now they're taking the USB port to the laptop, and they're calling this progress.
No, right?
Good job, Apple. Oz, you're an Apple user, aren't you? So, you're a snowflake.
And I think people who worry about connectors need something more important to worry about.
You have to travel with a laptop, and then you also have to bring like this special adapter for USB ports, but you also have to have a special adapter for the wall plug and all these special adapters, what's the point of having a laptop?
That's the great thing, Jess. They've integrated the weird wall plug adapter into the USB hub now.
Oh, so... So to plug it in, you have to use up the one USB port you get.
Yes. No. Here's the great part, though. You can use the USB ports while you have a USB port plugged into it, and then you're doing power pass through into your USB hub to charge the MacBook. It's so special.
It's a Mac thing. People don't understand.
I grew up in the networking world. I am so used to connectors changing that I got over it a long, long time ago.
I got over connectors changing until they started removing serial ports from motherboards. That made my life difficult.
Well, Apple has removed the optical drive, and now they're removing all these USB. Like, I have a laptop. It doesn't have an optical drive. It drives me crazy. It's a nice, fast laptop and everything, but sometimes I need a DVD or a CD or something, so I have to carry an extra thing.
That's why they make you buy a DVD drive that uses USB.
Yeah. Frustrating. Okay, thank you, Oz. Sorry I was late. At least I came.
No problem.
and have a good weekend.
And I'll see you in 2 weeks.
I've got uploads to do. I got to get this alpha out, or at least ready for...
One night off, so I need to go and sit and maybe fix Windows 32 bit tonight.
Yeah, see, that's the laptop. That's what I'm talking about. That's not the new laptop, though. Wait, is that the new laptop?